Thank you. Yo, what up? Did you? Neato.
So you're in the main game? Probably the hardest part of it. Especially if the next boss you have to fight is the Watcher. It's like, oh lord.
So then, I'm a sick fuck. Are you using a pistol or a shotgun? Sometimes if they're like really close and you try to counter shot them, like it just doesn't. It'll miss even if you have a shotgun. Gotcha. I like fighting them, so. The dogs always fuck me up, even though their movesets are really slow and dumb. Those hellhounds. Uncannily are just too nice.
Yeah.
back.
Thank you. best. Savage.
Strong.
Alive.
That's freaking out.
Fetuses. Oh, I know fetus. Supposed to be a lost Raita. Raider Palash? Palashy. In this dungeon. I don't know where it is. Fucking what?
It would be nice if there's a reason to play this game after you go into New Game Plus. Besides like playing with all your weapons. The one cool thing that Dark Souls 2 did was they changed up all the enemy spawns. They didn't change them up, but they added new enemies that would spawn in New Game Plus. And new items you could only get in New Game Plus. Yeah, it was pretty cool. That's the only reason why I played that game multiple times too. This is don't have it. Especially sad because there's all these like enemies you don't see in the main game. Sitting around in the chalice dungeons and you never see them. Like, unless you do the chalice dungeons. The chalice dungeons get really boring. Oh, it might have been behind him. Chest in there or nothing? No, guess not. Really? What? Fucking missed that. Alright, nope, nothing in here.
How's it going?
You're the wrong way.
So remember in Dark Souls, the Tomb of Giants? Did you ever, like, fully explore that place? Because I don't think I ever did. I mean, like... Because, like, you know, like, as soon as it gets dark? Like, super dark, and you slide down a couple of those things, but it's before you get to the part with patches? Like, there's, like, a whole pathway that leads all the way back up to the start, but I don't know how to... I don't remember ever, like, going through. I remember seeing, like, items that you have to fall to in fucking pitch dark, but I never got to them because of... How do you have your sights set up? Right. Exactly. See, I told you. It's when they're too close and it just fucking whips on them. That's the worst thing. Even if your timing's impeccable. Sometimes I'll be using Evelyn and then it'll just like shoot just right past them, like to their left or something. It, I don't know. It's on the skinnier enemies. And then when I try using the blunderbuss, sometimes that misses, and I don't understand how. Maybe it's because the end of the rifle is so far on Ludwig's. But it might happen with any gun. Again. for him, but... Are you on New Game Plus right now? Have you joined, do you have the Forbidden Woods unlocked yet? If you go there, you can join a new, covenant. And then you get access to all sorts of new summons. After you go to the Forbidden Woods, you can join a new covenant there. And it gives you access to new summons. When you're inside of dungeons, like even chalice dungeons and stuff, new summons should show up all over the place. It's pretty cool. Yeah. I mean, you don't need to. Distraction. The wormwood. Kill up the spiders. It's right in the windmill. Just go to the windmill shortcut and you should be standing there. You can get that in the DLC. Hey guys! I think around here. Didn't even stagger a single one. Well, the fuck is this? The ruin itself is pretty garbage, but if you put it on, then you get bonuses if you co-op, help people a lot on bosses. And then if you kill other hunters and stuff that invade. It only takes like 5 to reach the max in the Covenant 2, and then you get a emote and you get a just helmet, I think. Still have to do that on this character. Okay. I lied too. I was told that there's gonna be lost weapons in this dungeon, and all I've been finding are not lost weapons. Yeah, you know about the lost and uncanny weapons? Well, they're really fucking rare, and the last achievement in the game. Well, the two last achievements I have to get. Achievements. Trophies I have to get are collecting all the lost and uncanny variants of every type of weapon in the main game, which is gonna take goddamn forever, and beating the game by getting my head chopped off. Cause that's the only thing I haven't, it's the only ending I haven't gotten yet. That's the easiest one. I feel like I'm going in a circle. What the? What? Wait, hang on. Where the hell? Oh my goodness. Oh, this is gonna draw me absolutely insane. Where did I go wrong? Got turned around. So I played this dungeon 1,000 times. Maybe not this dungeon, but many others like it. Never gonna find where the fuck I'm going. Oh, here we go. Convenient. Ironic, even. Was doing anything? Oh. No. Not you. You monster. What are you? So you fought those giant roly-poly naked guys with a giant mace, right? Oh my god, they're terrifying. It's like fighting somebody in Dark Souls 1 that carries a big heavy weapon and rolls around all day. Oh my god, I'm gonna die here! He just sat on me. Yeah, basically. It's fucking hilarious. It's really fast, too. Oh, but I want the souls. That'll be enough for level up.
Are you still fighting the skeleton? What are you fighting?
Welcome home. What is
it? Oh my god, no. That thing's awful. Took me like 20 some tries to do it. You just gotta, I don't know, you just gotta lame it out. Because it can one-shot you with its dash attack and with its explodey attack after you wound its legs.
Very
it's gotta
well.
Stay in front of it.
Let the echoes become
attack
your
its legs
strength.
And it gives you a chance. Let me. Cosmically nightmarish blood echoes. Oh my god, 40,000 is so insane.
Welcome home, what is it? Very well, let me.
Oh, you're still fighting the cool hat witch. Yeah, I don't know. I was able to stunlock her. Or, like, you wail on it, and then you, shoot her with a shotgun, and then keep wailing on her. Or if you have the beast drawer, you can knock her down. Wail on her, knock her down, then, beast drawer. Until she's dead. Just you wait till you get to the fucking watchdog of the old lords, boyo. Secrets. Oh. They're hidden. They're very hard to tell. These treasures are garbage. I don't know. There's not really much of a reason. Burn through chalices. The only treasures that really matter are the, like, really good blood gems and, I guess, lost weapon. Well, then it doesn't even matter because... I don't know. I wish there were cooler things you could find down here. More tangible rewards. Yeah.
dead. Chalice dead. Come on. Damn, sick combo. I wish there was a Moonlight Greatsword variant that hit shot fire. That'd be dope. See, even... Come back here. Fight this boss first. What are we doing with here? The game locks people onto the center of a boss when you're fighting his ankles. A big boss. I better hit his torso, which is 14 feet above my person. No. And then he fucking the whole fight. Slapping that dude's ankles. Is that it then? Yeah, looks like. Let me go back and find that Reicha. Reicha. Is it pronounced? Right to Apollo. Yeah, I'm just swimming in pebbles. Maybe I should make a pebble build. Play through the entire game only using pebbles. What's the next chalice weapon we're going after? The Chikage, and I got the Raita. Blades of Mercy now. Alright, Blades of Mercy.
Welcome, what is it? Very well, let...
I don't have anything like Chalice Dungeons for Dark Souls 3. I haven't really been keeping up with any of the news for it, so I'm going into it blind. Sort of what I did for Bloodborne, I really liked it. Coming out this soon! All I've seen of it is like the really shitty trailers and some gameplay from the beta. Which looked weird because it was like 30 frames per second, even though the game runs at 60, so it was like all. Oh, it's weird, but it looks fucking great. Combat looks really fast. Like fast defensive combat, so it's less rolling and more like countering. Whereas this game, Bloodborne's more dodging than going back. Should be cool. I'm excited. But I wonder if they'll have some stupid bullshit forever dungeons like this game, or if they'll do it differently and better? Hopefully better? This is a pretty cool idea, but like... shit gets old. Oh, crap. I also miss being able to move around quickly while not getting staggered by the tiny little baby attack. Little baby attack. Thank God this game doesn't have, like, now I think about it, doesn't have like enemies that attack right away, like super duper fast, that fucking staggy for miles. It does, but like they're few and far between compared to some other Fair Souls games. Where do I? Oh, it's a big dumb empty room. I also hope, it's more like a mixture of Dark Demon Soul or I hope it's a mixture of Dark Souls in this game rather than Dark Souls 2. I don't want anything to do with that Dark Souls 2. The hitboxes? Phil, do you remember the hitboxes? Phil, you can hear. I fought that very first boss, like the Lost Giant. Oh my god, it was so easy, and then I tried fighting again, New Game Plus, shit was impossible. I was getting hit like miles away, I was in a different area code, and the guy's fucking attack still hitting me. That game too featured many ankles. Many bosses where their ankles are the weak spot. I hope that isn't a continuing trend. I want to fight bosses that are human-sized. Or at least, like, slightly bigger than human-sized. Or at least not fucking giant ankles attached to a larger thing that's attacking you. Congratulations. You won. Can heal? Oh my god. Might just be my new favorite enemy. Sweet, amazing. You have to hit him. Fucking mash the X button. And then like sometimes they're in the dumbest spots ever. The dumbest spots. So what was... Was there anything that you preferred in Dark Souls 2 over Dark Souls 1? Or Bloodborne? I don't think... For me, I don't think there's anything. Even like the equipment load thing, which is a neat idea, but like, I don't know. I liked having those set boundaries. Give you like more options. I did like that you could teleport to places once you found the bonfire, so you had less time wandering around for fucking years, or heading back. That's probably the one thing. Cause I hated that in Dark Souls and subsequent playthroughs, having to like run through everything, and then like if you forgot one thing, you'd have to run all the way back. What else?
Farewell, good hunt.
That's the Dark Souls. The Berserkers. These guys are pretty cool, I like them. I also liked... I don't want to say Dark Souls 2 is a story. It's okay, but it's too laid out, I think. But I like the characters in it. Like that cat. It's a cool cat. For that, for all the defiled, yeah. The last part, no. The very last one, and you don't have that. But I believe the enemies do more damage in the second one. They're different somehow. So it doesn't even matter whether you have full health or not. All I know is that the fucking, the watchdog of the old lords is the hardest boss. Take a lot of tries. Maybe, I don't know. I guess it's different for everybody. I know I took a lot of guardian tries on. Dark Souls 3 is gonna be. Well, now I'm getting hype. I'll have to look up some information on it. Learn the deets. People freak out at this. You ever fought one of those? Have you ever died to one of those insect things with the glowing green tail? Scorpion? I Every time, well, a lot of times when I run into one, they take forever to fucking kill, but like, people, I'll always see comments from down saying like, beware of insects! And like, that's like the only message I see through the whole dungeon. And it's like, it's not that bad, guy. It's just a little insect, probably. And I've never been killed by it. I think it inflicts rapid poison, but it's like no big deal. I don't know. It's like those frogs from Dark Souls 1. And I've never been cursed. I never understood why people freak the fuck out. But then I realized that's because they can curse you. There's Valentine stuff going on again in Grand Theft Auto. Deleted that data. It's true. Do all the heists in it? My favorite thing to do. So you did all the Lamar missions too? I never done all that. Is that the only weapon in this one? Wait, no. It was. So I still have to do the Lamar missions, and that's about it. Besides the infinite number of missions there are to do in that game. I still can't believe how expensive those lowriders are. They should be expensive, but not like a million. No. I didn't want to go in. Dungeons are the worst. Nah, man. This fat naked dude rolls around super fast. You'll see him. You'll know. When you see him, you'll know. It's terrifying. Please. Don't want to have to nerf me. Oh my god. Circles around. Here we go. Nipping at me heels. Hang on. Something's fishy here. This layer. Fucking game. Thank you. shit, must have been back here someplace. Probably behind a hidden door. Let's go in circles again. Ah. Just sight. There's nothing here. There is something here. Oh, there's nothing here. There it. Oh man, what a fool. What a fool I was. It's like a door right at the start of the dungeon, and I've been looking just past that point all over. Yeah. Well now, what do we have here? Okay. All right, fuck this stuff. I wish there were more hunters that you had to fight in the game, but there aren't. Give good practice for PvP too. I can't remember where the guy he is. We're gonna get another blood rack. fight? Nah, sure, fuck it. As well. Two of those? Do those only play? Oh no, wait! That does blood attack and that. Oh, did I waste? Yeah, that one would have been better. Fuck! Because I could have put blood pin things all over that. Come back. Yeah, I could have slapped that one in there. Well, I have it now. Sorry. Had a phone call. Okay, now I got two viable weapons. I showed you Simon's bow blade, didn't I, though? So, yeah, it's pretty dope, I like it, especially since I never use, wait, oh, yeah, go back in, since I never use, or I have, like, unlimited Quicksilver now, I can just spam them bows for days! And if I use my health vials right, then I have even hella-er amount. After this dungeon, I'll do the one for the plus 5 vials. Both kinds. I didn't get the other one. I only use this one. Up here. Nah. Oh! Oh! Music my cuteness control. What's up? Yeah, I think I'll get the extra vials. Yes, you gotta do much of an awful lot this game. That's oh, it's a cursed one too. Oh wait, they're both on the same level? Well, shit, okay. PD5.
what up?
Wait, that isn't... I hate you! You're not supposed to be here! Oh no! Remember that one hunter from the... the chalice? The Great Chapel who always uses those goddamn... Yeah. He's in the skeleton. Well, it's not the same thing, actually. Yeah, he's got the armor and everything. Yeah, he's got the same. You motherfucker! Had a lot of bad times. Got like this army of fucking. Oh my god. I can't believe that can fucking counter me. Dude, it's so dumb! That's the dumbest thing ever! Oh, that's so dumb. The worst part about the bow blade is if you get shot while you're shooting a bow, it's as if you were doing a normal attack, which causes you to get put into the counter stance. Making it the worst fucking thing ever. And if you're at range, yeah, it's okay, it's fine, it's not that big of a deal. But guess what? That doesn't matter. Doesn't matter because we'll still die. What do you do here, man? Run through it? The fuck should I do? This hell beast here again? It doesn't help that, like, every couple seconds, there's an army of these fucking red spiders which spawns behind him, and someone can track me halfway through the dungeon. I really hope they understand. No, no reason to play. I only had to stick him with like 20 arrows and I had to kill him. That's fine. Earn this motherfucking moon.
Welcome home. Very well, let.
Well, I don't know if I've ever been good enough. A little bit of a steal. Going full fuck it. mode right now. You ain't fucking with no one, nobody at any point. Is it right here? Please. Faster to be strong. Does kill them all. That's it then. No. No. Oh, you can hurt in their enemies? What? Is he really gonna stay in their neutral state till he dies?
But he is.
What a fucking idiot! No. Fucking watch this. Amazing. Good fight. Ooh. That's a spicy blood gem. There it is. Just abandon.
No.
I'm guessing the other one is right. Hey there, puppy. Do you have situational awareness? Aw, you don't. You don't know what is going on. What a cool enemy. Wish there were more of them. Level up again.
Welcome home. What is very well?
Oh shit, he wants to fight! God, it's too bad. Ah, you again. Here I was, thinking I could have a nice fair fight against two monsters with giant flaming swords at the same time, and then no, you just gotta come and ruin it. Come and ruin it. It's ruining my time. Whatever. I really wanna fight these guys though. It's a cool fight. Fight me, man. do one-on-one. So I just killed an enemy that dropped 80,000 souls just for killing me. It's a normal enemy. No, it's normal enemy. Oh shit. Oh no, it's all over. It's all over. No man. Fine. Fine! Where are you? Better come here. That guy only dropped 41,000 souls. Okay. Let it go. Oh, you motherfucker! Fine. What a dumb bear. Okay, this is all right. How was that? The never-ending circle! Yeah. There it is. Wait, what am I doing? Why am I fighting you like a human being? You die. You can die just like this. And then you drop 98,000 souls, so I guess that's okay. Yeah. I know, these blecos are off the heasel. Aside from the hunter, they're not hard to get either. If I just bait those two guys up the, up the ladder, Jesus. Super easy. Fuck do I want to die? Not this one, you fall off of that. Well, hey there! Aww, oh jeez. What? Huh? Oh. Where are you? Oh, you're a copycat. Yeah. health. Oh, you bitch! How dare you disrespect what I've been doing this entire fight. Jesus Christ. Souls. And a blood gem, nice. It's very nice. Approve wholeheartedly. Using your holy blade? Whatever. These hunters are bad. Whatever. Keep going. Really? What did I do? Spideys. Okay. More or less. Hello there, Lord. Oh, that's all I wanted from you. I wonder how they're handling death in the next Dark Souls. It's gonna be like Dark Souls 2 where eventually it became a problem, or if it's like Dark Souls 1 where if you're dead then you can't summon people, but otherwise it's not a problem. Or this game where it doesn't matter and it makes the game quite far less tedious. It needs to be different. I hope it goes for this game. Oh, girl. 360 though. Is it better than... It does... Oh, it's triangle. Fight them in the alien brain. Not even wearing the right leggings. Where are they? I'm wondering about that. I'll go back to the main game for a bit. Where did I leave off here? Go to the forest. We'll be right back.
Okay, that's a lot. That shoots? What about a regular shot? Nope, strong shot. God, if this parried people as well as fucking I, oh man. I'm too strong. Let's see what I can do. I guess I'll help people.
Oh. With channel lane without before it turned to nighttime. I've only seen this in the trailers when it's daytime. It's cool looking.
Oh, that looks cool!
But you're supposed to come this way early or some shit? I don't know about that.
Do you hear the grave, Dennis?
Phil, do you remember back in, are you there? Phil, no, let me find it. Do you remember back in Dark Souls 2 right after you beat the torture guy? Like, you had to go into that boat You have to like go into an underground cavern, and then there is a boat, and then you go into like the hull of the boat, and then you kill that thing that one boss that could fight in both directions. Yeah. And then the boat takes off, and then it sends you to the that one fortress. And then you have to walk across the planks and then like go up that elevator. Remember when you got to the planks, were you playing online and did you just remember seeing all the fucking blood stains from people that just walked? Like, oh my god. I just thought of that. Love it. Girlfriend. Did you know that there is one enemy? Ah! There's one enemy in the game that won't. There's this crow in the middle of a horde of other crows, like five other crows in Hemlock Champions. Which just sits there. It doesn't aggro on you. All the other crows around it aggro, but it doesn't aggro. Of course, most people will notice it because they just like slam jam and like attack without thinking about it. But there's this little crow. He just won't. And no matter what, he won't aggro. It's pretty. I don't know. It's sort of interesting. I don't know why it's here, but. See, I'll send you a picture. Having a little bonfire. Why can't I share anything? It's because I'm broadcasting. Probably. Oh well. With that boss. popular bloodborne is considering how like American, well not American, but like how Western the influence of kind of like storing the game for it.
Yep. I did solo because someone fell too fast and that boss already has a lot of health. Wait, is Kane hers? The Forbidden Woods area. This means I have to fight Vicar Amelia in New Game 3. I just had the memo involved with it. It's lightning or damage. And also his two front legs. His head is really heavy armored as well as his back legs are kind of really tough, but he always will get away from his back. So I think you need to watch out for the bullshit one. If he likes to do it if you're like on your side. But like his neck, like side to side, swings are one, like the most telegraphed attack and the one that's easiest to dodge. If he just dodges from the direction that he's doing it, where he like swings his head, you have to learn how to dodge through those. Then slice his leg a couple times and back off. And then usually he does some other crazy shit, but it's pretty easily dodged. The only things that are tough is when you do cut his leg, then he falls down and then he explodes, so you have to watch out for that. And that jump forward, that lunge forward, those are the only things that are really problematic. And the fact that he controls him is so much better.
Thank you.
No. It's a straight fight of just dodging and timing and stuff. And then being plain safe, landing out with him. I'd say it's the hardest fight other than the final boss for DS. At halfway, then he gets stronger. Then he does the combos with the side-to-side face swipe and starts barking fire, but otherwise it's the same fight.